Following Napoleon's defeat, the victors of the Napoleonic Wars, Austria, Great Britain, Russia, and Prussia, met in Vienna in 1815. Their host was the foreign minister, Prince Clemens von Metternich of Austria, a Catholic German. The Congress reinstalled Louis XVIII as the new monarch, so the new French government represented by Talleyrand was welcomed as a friend. However, the principal objective of the Metternich system was to form an alliance between all the parties. If one country seeks to dominate the rest, the others will stand against it. This is classic balance of power. However, every country has its own national interest. The Russians wanted to dominate the Poles, thereby forcing the Austrians to withdraw, and Prussia wanted more German areas. When France, Britain, and Austria opposed the annexations, both Prussia and Russia would have to back down. Also, remember that Britain had a constitutional monarchy. It could not have cared if liberal revolution occurred inside Europe. Its main security problem was to check France from becoming strong again. A great book to read would be The Rise and Fall of the Great Powers by Paul Kennedy. It deals with these empires during this period and explain why some empires grew larger and others were declining. This is a map of Europe in 1815. What you have to understand is the difference between liberalism and conservatism. Liberalism is when people are open-minded to change, whereas conservatives want to keep in power, they want to keep the status quo, they do not want any change. When Napoleon's forces marched eastward and overtook Prussia and Austria and the Italian city-states, he installed liberal states that kicked out the nobility and the monarchs. It gave poor people more rights. These people now have to deal with the post-Napoleonic world where the monarchs came back to power, as did the nobility. Once you give certain people freedoms, it's very difficult to take them away. So Napoleon was liberal, and now the Metternich system is conservative. They're trying to go back to the way things were. This would cause problems. Additionally, inside of Austria, inside of Metternich's Austria, the area in the light blue is the Germanic area. But notice all the other different ethnicities. You had the Magyars in gray, who are Hungarian. You had Italians, Romanians, Polish, Slovak, Czechs. Only 25% of the population of Austrian Empire was German, meaning 75% were other people. Those people had experienced certain freedoms under Napoleon, and they no longer wanted to be governed by the minority Germans. They wanted independence. They wanted their own homelands. So this would be a problem for Austria, and the reason why Metternich wanted this concert of Europe, to prevent instability. And revolutions would occur very quickly. The first test was in Spain in 1820. A revolution occurred inside Spain, threatening the conservative monarchy. The Concert of Europe thought a new liberal republic would be created, and in 1823, the French sent in 100,000 troops to put down the revolution. So while the Spanish Revolution was quelled, all of its Latin American empire declared independence. For example, Mexico, Central and South America. Only Cuba and Puerto Rico remained tied to the Spanish. The Italian states also started to rise up in 1821. Italy was split apart by the French and the Austrians and other independent Italian states. The Italian nationalistic spirit, arisen by the Napoleonic Wars, wanted total independence and the creation of an Italy. The concert of Europe was too strong and these rebellions were put down only to smolder for the future. In Russia, Tsar Alexander I dies and his brother Nicholas I takes over. A group of junior officers called the Decembrists did not like the aristocracy in Russia and attempted a revolution. They did not have full backing of the society, and Nicholas I uses force to crush the revolution. The leaders are executed and the Tsar forms a secret police to spy on any possible dissenters. In Greece, 1829, a liberal revolution did result in the freeing of Greece in 1829 from the sick man of Europe, the Ottoman Empire. The Ottomans, based in modern Turkey, were Muslims and had reached the gates of Vienna in the 1300s prior to being pushed back. They still had an empire in the Balkans, southeastern Europe, which would come unglued in the late 1800s. The concert supported the Greek liberals only because the Greeks were Christian, Greek Orthodox, and historically they wanted to liberate the land of Aristotle and Plato. Britain also supported the Greeks for fear that Russia, the Tsar, was considered the protector of the Greek Orthodox and might seize more territory from the Ottomans. So while the first few revolutions were put down by the Concert of Europe, the Concert of Europe disliked the Ottoman Empire and they would allow the Greeks to gain independence.